are investing in Facebook, Twitter, our friends, and so on and so forth, then this is what our friends will be. But these friends will not be able to accompany us in the grave. These friends will not be able to be accompanying us when we are resurrected. So it's very wise and important and smart of us to invest in our time and relationship with Qur'an. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Bismillah walhamdulillah wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. So we'll be discussing a very important topic today in the short 10 minutes or so, which is barriers to using your superpower. Barriers to using your superpower. So if I were to bring in a MacBook Pro with a nice box, silver color, and 19-inch retina display, and I tell you that this machine right here can do a lot of different things for you. It can send text messages, it can send emails, it can do a video conference call, it can let you speak to someone all the way in Australia. And I tell you something more. I say, hey, you know what? It can also let you spy. It can let you influence the world elections. And I tell you, it can let you break a car. You know the automatic cars these days? It can actually break that car. It can cause an accident. It can interact with a pacemaker and disturb someone's heartbeats and cause death. It can interact with hospital systems. And then I tell you that it can mine digital currency for you. It can make money for you while you sleep without doing anything. If I tell you all those things, would you believe me? And what needs to happen for you to take advantage of all those things? If you take that amazing looking box, you don't make an unpacked video from that box, and you put it up on the shelf, what will happen? Will you be able to influence the elections? Will you be able to make crypto coins? Will you be able to have a Facebook or a FaceTime video call with your loved ones? Wouldn't happen, right? So for you to be able to use that, there's certain things that need to happen. You need to overcome those barriers for you to be able to take advantage of that MacBook Pro. Okay, now we're gonna change the topic a bit and we'll come back to the MacBook Pro later. So if you have seen a karate kid, a 9-year-old kid who is shown a wooden block and he kicks it and it breaks, you may be more powerful with you may be more powerful than the kid, but you are not able to break that wooden block. Why is that so? Is that all about physical strength, muscle combination? Is it about training, or is there something else to it? What is required other than the muscle combination and training for the kid to be able to break through that wooden block? Okay, let's go back to another topic now. What happens if you are going for the job interview of your life? You're going to work for a company that you have been desiring to work for. You've gone to university for years and years. You've done your graduate studies. You have attained your PhD. You are a doctor now. You earned your doctorate degree, and then you go for a job interview. But there's a thing. You have been using that MacBook Pro that I gave you, and these guys will be giving you a Linux computer. A Linux computer, and you'll be able to show and demonstrate your skills while you're on a Linux computer. Anybody heard of Linux? Okay, think of Microsoft Surface Pro for now. So think, so something different, totally different. You don't know how to use that? They'll put that screen up. Go ahead, show us what you know. Do the communications now. Show us what you know. What happens? So if I tell you 10 years ago that, hey, the job interview that you're going to go for will not use this MacBook Pro, and it will be using the Linux computer. Will you train on the Linux computer or the MacBook Pro? Something to think about. So let's go back to the MacBook Pro now. So for me, telling you that this is able to do all those things, the first thing that needs to happen is you need to trust me. You need to trust me that the box the machine in the box is actually able to do all the stuff that I've told you. That's the step number one. If you trust me, what shall happen next for you to be able to take advantage of that box? What shall happen? Anyone? Okay, I hear people saying I need to learn how to use that. And then start using it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That we have sent down in Qur'an what is a cure. And it's a mercy for the believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that Qur'an is a guidance for the believers. And the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us something super important. So you know sometimes a kid asks that which superpower would you like to have? If you have the ability to choose a superpower from Batman, Superman, Spider-Man, Flash, which superpower would you like to have? So if we change the question a bit, and you think about if you had the ability to witness any miracle or have access to any miracle from all the prophets that have come so far. So you have a staff that turns into a snake. You're able to split the sea. You're able to resurrect dead. You're able to cure the blind. And so on and so forth. Which superpower, which miracle would you like to witness or have access to? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, and I'm paraphrasing here, that every messenger, every prophet was given a miracle or more, which caused the people to believe in the messenger. But what the Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been given is Qur'an. And because of that, he expects that he will have the most number of followers. And the news is that we have access to Qur'an. So compare that to all the other miracles, resurrecting dead, being able to cure the sick, and so on and so forth. We have access to Qur'an. Now I would like to remind you again what I was telling you earlier about the MacBook Pro. First, you have to remember and believe that all those things that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised us are true. وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. Who is more truthful in his speech than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So if that is the case for Qur'an, then the only shortcoming is within us. Either we are not believing completely, or we are not trying hard enough, or there are other obstacles that we need to overcome. So let's go back to it. Let's focus on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us about Qur'an and what are some of the obstacles that we might be having that we are not overcoming. So remember the example of that karate kid. For him to be able to break through that thick wooden block, he needs to actually believe that he can do it. If he does not believe, he will not commit. He will not put his full power and the board will not break. He will get hurt. His confidence will decrease. And that's what happens when we put the Qur'an up on the shelf. Or we just make it to be recited and not to be understood and not to be acted upon. So we'll only get what we commit to. When I talked about the relationship idea, like if your interview will be using a Linux laptop and you do not invest time in understanding a Linux laptop, you will not be able to succeed. The most important interview that we will have will be when we are dead. When we are dead. And when we will be asked the three questions. If we are not preparing for that, if we are not connecting with Quran for that, if we are not looking forward to that, then we will not be able to pass that interview. So these are some of the important things that you and I all need to think about. To what extent is our relationship with Quran is increasing day by day, and week by week, and month by month, and year by year. So that's something very, very important for all of us to think about. So if we are investing in Facebook, Twitter, our friends, and so on and so forth, then this is what our friends will be, but these friends will not be able to accompany us in the grave. These friends will not be able to be accompanying us when we are resurrected. So it's very wise and important and smart of us to invest in our time and relationship with Qur'an. Now let me take another angle to that. So they showed me that if I press this button right there, the mic will turn off. And when I press it on, it will turn on. So I came up, I was very certain that if I press this button, I will be able to speak to you guys and I won't have to shout louder than what I'm already doing. I'll be able to address all of you. I was very certain and confident in the capability of this button. Now imagine if I told you that there's a switch, you press that switch and you will be happy. If you are feeling lonely, you press that switch and you will not be feeling lonely. If you're feeling depressed, you press that switch and you won't be feeling depressed. If you're sad, you won't be feeling sad and you will be happy. Now this switch is what the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us, that anyone who is feeling anxiety or depression or sadness, if he were to recite the dua that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught the companions, then Allah will replace his sadness with happiness. And a part of that dua is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make Qur'an the spring of our heart, the light of our chest, and give us the ability that Qur'an removes the sadness and sorrows that we have. So again, this is another thing that we need to know that Qur'an is able to do. So the deficiency is in the user of the product. The deficiency is the user who is not using the product properly in the example of the MacBook Pro. So if we have that switch available to us, if we do not invest with having a relationship with that switch, then we will not be able to remove our sadness with happiness. So something to think about. Now if I were to give you some action points on how you can start doing that, you can start slow but commit to at least reading one page a day. If you're already doing that, then increase that and be consistent with that. And when you open the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, read the translation, read the meanings, and ask certain questions to yourself. Ask, what is this kitab, what is this verse, what is this page telling me about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is there a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this page? Is there a deal? Is there a trade? Is there a tijara that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is offering us that if I were to commit my part, Allah will give me the results that He has promised? Is there a better, a more empowering mindset that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching me in this page? Is there something else that I need to be focusing on that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching me? Are there qualities that are being shown to me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves? Are there qualities that are being shown to me that Allah hates? And how do I compare in terms of those qualities? So once you start doing that, you will identify your own personal gems. Write them down. Capture them. Take a picture of them. Put it on your wallpaper. Be friends with them. Let them direct your life. Then you take it to the next level and you start memorizing. Imagine you can't memorize. If that's what you think, I can't memorize the whole Quran. Can you memorize one page a week or a page a month? Start the journey and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will count you as those who are on the journey of memorization. Even if you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without completing your memorization. And take it to the next level and start this routine with your family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make Quran a hujjah for us. Something that will argue to protect us from the punishment on the day of judgment. And not a hujjah against us. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.